Water jug problem. It is a very famous, common and classical problem. So the problem is something like this. You are given two jugs, a 4-liter one and a 3-liter one. A pump which has unlimited water which you can use to fill the jug, and the ground on which the water can be poured also. So from the jug, the water can be poured on the ground. We're having one pump with the help of which we can fill up this 4-liter jug and 3-liter jug, and we're having infinite water supply. Neither jug has any measuring mark on it. How can you get exactly 2 liters of water in the 4-liter jug? So that is a problem. So here we must be having at the end that 2-liter water in the 4-liter jug. But mind it, there is no measuring mark will be there either on the 4-liter jug or on the 3-liter jug. So state representation and the initial state. We will represent a state of the problem as a tuple xy, where x represents the amount of water in the 4-liter jug and y represents the amount of water in the 3-liter jug. So note that x will be ranging in between 0 to 4 and y will be ranging in between 0 to 3. Our initial state is 0, 0, that means jugs are empty, and our goal predicate is that we'll be having 2, y, because the 4-liter jug must have 2 liters of water, and regarding y, the y will be ranging in between 0 to 3 inclusive of the limits, because the jug may be empty, can have 3 liter water or in between any other volume. So here is one solution we are having, and we must define a set of operators that will take us from one state to the another state. So first consideration is our fill 4-liter jug. So we can have this one. Initially, if the x value is less than 4, then only you can pour water onto the 4-liter jug, and the ultimate state will be 4y. Fill 3-liter jug, if y is less than 3, then only there is a scope to pour water on the 3-liter jug, and ultimately the state will be x3. Empty 4-liter jug on ground. So if x is greater than 0, if there is some water in the 4-liter jug, then only you can pour the water on the ground, and then ultimately the state will be 0, y, that means 0 amount of water in the 4-liter jug and y will remain the same. Empty 3-liter jug on ground, that can be possible if and only if the 3-liter jug is having at least some water, so y must be greater than 0, and ultimately our state will be x, 0. Pour water from 3-liter jug to fill 4-liter jug. So that means I'll be taking water from the 3-liter jug to fill up this 4-liter jug. In that case, the constraints will be like this. That means x plus y must be ranging in between 0 to greater than equal to 4, and y must be greater than 0. That means the 3-liter jug must be having some water at the beginning. Pour water from 4-liter jug to fill 3-liter jug. So that's the opposite one. So here is the constraint for us. In this way, we are having the other constraints. You can find that how the state transitions will take place, under which conditions and constraints we have mentioned that one in this respective list. So here we are going to have one solution for you. Initially, two jugs will be empty, so 0, 0, and at first we shall pour full water, that means it will fill up the 3-liter jug in this way, so 0, 3. That 3-liter of water will be poured onto the 4-liter jug, so that is 4, that is 3, 0. Next one is that again the 3-liter jug will be filled up completely, so it will become 3, 3. Now this particular 3-liter jug, from this 3-liter jug, we shall pour water onto the 4-liter jug. So what will happen? It can take 1 liter and 2 liter will remain in the 3-liter jug. So it is 4, 2. So now we shall pour all the water from this 4-liter jug. So it will become empty. So 0, 2. So ultimately the 3-liter jug, which was having 2 liter water, will be poured onto the 4-liter jug. So ultimately we are going to get this 2, 0, and that is our goal state. So in this way, using diagrams, using pictures, we have demonstrated but how to implement the same in prologue. So here we are going to implementation demonstration of this problem in Prologue. Please watch that one.
So this is the implementation of water jug problem in Prologue. So here we are considering two jugs. The first jug is of capacity 4 liters and second jug with the capacity of 3 liters. So here this water jug is the predicate, and here the first argument, that is x, is denoting the current content of the 4 liter jug, and y is denoting the current content of the 3 liter jug. So if x is greater than 4 and if y is within the limits, then 4 liter jug is causing overflow. That is quite obvious. But on the other hand, if x is less than 4, that means within the limit, and y is greater than 3, that indicates that 3 liter water jug is causing overflow. On the other hand, if both the values x and y, both the variable values are crossing their respective limits, that is 4 and 3 respectively, then both water jug is causing overflow. So these are the messages are going to get printed. Okay, now see. So here we are considering that initially we shall give one query where water jugs will remain empty. So I can make either the first water jug filled up with 4 liters or the second water jug filled up with the 3 liters. So in this case, when x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0, that means we are going to put, that is, the 4 liter water jug will remain empty and 3 liter water jug will get filled up with 3. So respectively, we have written the code here. Here we have put one semicolon, indicates that it is getting connected the next statement with the OR logic. So here we are considering that we shall fill up the 4 liter jug, and in the first case we have considered that we shall fill up the 3 liter jug at first. So similarly, other situations whatever might be coming in our execution of this program, for each and every we have defined the respective rules, that what are the rules we are going to apply when such situation are coming. So when x is equal to 2, y is equal to 0 means the 4 liter jug is containing 2 liter water and the 3 liter jug is containing empty or void or no water is there. In that case, our goal state will be reached, because that is our target to reach. That means the 4 liter jug will be containing 2 liter water and the 3 liter jug will remain empty. Then that is a only one case where we will be reaching to the goal state. Otherwise, for different scenarios, what are the respective rules are to be executed, we have written the code here. The entire code is in front of you. You can easily go through them. So for the better understanding, let us go for the execution of the program. So here we have loaded my program. We have loaded our program, and the program has been compiled and it is loaded in the memory. So if I put this one as 10.0, then obviously 4 liter jug is causing overflow. And if you go for this one as 10, keeping this one as say 0, then 3 liter jug is causing overflow. And in this way, we are getting this answer. So if we make this one as 2010, we are getting both water jugs is causing overflow. They are causing overflow. Okay, now let us go for the query, that is water jug 0, 0. Then here you see, here we are starting that with the 3 liter jug completely filled up. Then this water will be put in the 4 liter jug. Accordingly, we have written the respective action in our English sentences. So 3 liter jug will be filled up again. So fill up 3 liter jug, and then here 1 liter it can be poured onto this because it is having a capacity of 4 liters. So pour water from 3 liter jug to 4 liter jug until 4 liter jug is completely full. So now we have got this 2 liter in the 3 liter jug, but it has to be transferred to the 4 liter jug. So we are just making this one empty. 4 liter jug is making this one empty. And this 2 liter water is being poured onto the 4 liter jug. So now this is the situation where you can easily state that we have reached to the goal state. So now let me go for the other solution, where we shall start filling up our 4 liter jug completely. So this is our another solution here. So 4 liter jug is completely filled up, 3 liter jug is empty, and now this 3 liter will be poured here. It is with that one only. And now it will be made 0, so empty 3 liter jug. So we are keeping this 1 liter to the 1 liter from the 4 liter jug to the 3 liter jug. So pour water from 4 liter to 3 liter jug. So now it is empty. We are again making that one fill, completely filled up with the 4 liter water, and now it is having the 1 liter remaining. So we can pour another 2 liters here, so it will become 3 liters, and it is now with the 2 liters. So water poured from 4 liter jug to 3 liter jug until 3 liter jug is completely filled. So now we are having this 2 liter water on the 4 liter jug, and this 3 liter jug is completely empty, and that is our desired goal state to be reached. So in this way, we have written our code, we have shown you that how the program is getting executed for different kinds of input queries. I think now the conception is getting clear to you. Thanks for watching this video.